Hello everyone! Today we talk about audiophily, or the bug of HiFi. Some people have it. Everyone has the potential to be an audiophile, but not everyone is one. One thing that is sure is that it takes one audiophile to create another audiophile. There's a system that needs to be there, a sound system that needs to be there of high caliber, and that you listen for the first time and realize, okay, there can be that many details in a song. You can feel you're almost there. And hopefully the same person can explain how the gear works. Because it's not that easy to learn by yourself. Now the question today is, do people listen fully to music? And I insist on the word fully when people don't care about their sound system or the equipment, and they don't care how they could improve it to get more information, more of the music. I will invite in this episode a dear YouTuber, Steve Guttenberg, the Audiophiliac, to explain the same point. It's in a video called Do Normal People, aka Non-Audiophiles, Listen to Music Without Multitasking? Stay tuned in this video, you might become an audiophile yourself, if you're not already one. When you look at a picture, do you don't care of the quality of the picture, or do you do care of all the details and the resolution and the paper if it's a physical picture? Do you get more out of the picture? Do you get more feelings out of it? Same principle apply to hi-fi, to the high quality of sound and visuals. In the last episode, episode 69, I did a comparison between cables and an audiophile computer, and Bluetooth and a cell phone. The difference was really revealing. So today's theme is, do people listen fully to music? People do listen to music a lot. They do when they drive, they do when they wash the dishes, they do when they ride in the subway, they do when they go at the gym, when they do something. But when is the last time you sat down in front of your speakers and listened, fully listened to the music, to the whole chain that generates vibrations and the quality of these vibrations on your body and ears? With the creation of different type of speakers, tweeters, woofers and subwoofers, audiophiles have been able to cover the whole range of vibrations that our ears can perceive, from 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. Now these vibrations, audiophiles also discovered, and we discovered that also in the last episode, that vibrations affect digital signal and analog signals. So vibrations that are what audiophiles are seeking are affecting negatively the vibrations that the audiophiles are seeking. Audiophiles are also considering all the factors that can affect the sound. And it becomes a science, a passion, an art, many things. So let's listen now. Let's invite in the conversation Steve Guttenberg.
Hey friends, my name is Steve Guttenberg and I am the Audiophiliac, and I have a question. Do you know anybody who isn't an audiophile who owns an audio system of some type? Before I forget, I'm going to do a quick music review at the end of this video. So the question I'm asking is, I mean an audio system, in other words, a pair of speakers, an amplifier of some sort, and a turntable or CD player or something like that. And that they actually sit and listen to this at some point without multitasking. So in other words, I'm also including in this question, like, people you know who you didn't personally help them buy an audio system or give them an audio system. Just people you know, cousins, friends, coworkers, etc., who happen to also own audio systems, as I described. Because I get the feeling that audio systems are pretty rare, that normal people, the rest of the human race other than us audiophiles, doesn't own audio systems anymore. They use music basically as background in the bathroom or kitchen or something while they're shaving or frying eggs or something. And they don't, the idea would never really cross their mind of sitting and listening to music in any kind of focused way. But that just doesn't really happen anymore. I'm not putting it down. I'm not saying that there's anything wrong with that. I'm just saying that it didn't used to be this way. Back in the olden days, in the pre-internet days, normal people who were never ever audiophiles in any sort would listen to music without multitasking. It was a common occurrence. My mother did it frequently. Just people did it. It was a thing, you know. Music was important enough for, to them that they would sit and listen to it without doing other things. From time to time. I'm not saying that's the only way they ever had music on, but they did. They listened.
So, yes, the society has changed from the 70s or 60s even the 80s. But it's true that with the arrival of, you mentioned the internet for distribution of music, but prior than that, maybe 10 years prior than that, microcomputers changed music, because, and TV as well, when the video clip arrived, music became visual, and music started to have competition from social media and video games. So less time for pure music where you sit down in front of your computers. The world has changed.
And now they don't. And I guess the question is then, what would it take to get them to listen? Or could we ever get them back to listening? In other words, could music ever be that important again to the average person that they would listen to it without multitasking? Never say never. That's my thing. I think that that could happen. I just can't imagine the circumstances of that happening. But it will, because things are always cyclical. But music is so convenient now that you don't have to do much to play a given piece of music, so it doesn't demand anything from you. Now, of course, the other extreme is playing records. Or the real extreme is playing the instrument yourself and singing yourself. That would be the ultimate in focus, right? Is that you're an actual musician of some sort, or an amateur who knows how to play guitar or flute or something, and you played music, and it was important enough that you went through the effort of making music. But a couple of notches down from that would be playing an LP record or a single, 45 single. You had to get up, go over.
That's a point that he's making, is if you mastered the whole chain of production, that's something I've learned over the last 3 years. When you sing and you hear yourself through the whole chain of equipment, and you record your voice and process it and distribute it and hear comments and produce the videos with it, and you see comments and you change and you hopefully improve. But it definitely changes the way your relationship to music and to equipment. I became more interested in equipment the day I started to sing and saw the difference over my voice. So I hope that the learnings from HiFi can apply to production as well. The production world. In the next video, episode 81, I'll explain equipment, and I'll explain as well production equipment, which will help hopefully your understanding of music when you listen afterwards.
Get the record, put it on your turntable, start the motor on the turntable, put the arm over the leading groove, lower the stylus into the groove and play the record, and then 22 minutes later get up, do the whole thing all over again. That's commitment. I'm not expecting that from too many people, but just the ability to say, I want to hear My Fair Lady or something, and then stream it or do something and then listen to it. I gather that's a rare thing. What do you think? In other words, do you know people that do that aren't also audiophiles already? And I know some of you don't self-identify as audiophiles, but in my book, anybody who does that, who who does focus listening from time to time is an audiophile. I think that's the only qualifier. It's not really how good the playback system is. It's whether or not you can listen to music without multitasking. That's the Steve Guttenberg version of what an audiophile is. So anyway, I'd love to hear your comments. Please do so below.
Well, one thing that is sure is for someone to become an audiophile, you need another audiophile, as I mentioned. And I invite audiophiles to consider inviting people to listen their own sound system so it can open ears. Also, if you're non-audiophiles and you'd like to know, if you know people, ask if you can hear a sound system, or you can go in any store where they sell equipment, and they will be pleased to have you listen any sound system you desire without having any obligation to purchase. It's a learning. You can educate your ears. You can meet people who know about music equipment, audio equipment, and you'll develop your ear. And as much as you listen and meet people and learn, you'll cultivate the expertise of listening, which is more important than the gear. And less important maybe than the music itself. Some audiophiles also are contemplating moving to visuals, having AV receivers, because music with music videos and video games and even movies, but also artists like Ari Mack make music visually. And platforms like YouTube and Netflix and gaming platforms are becoming important distribution platform for music. So thank you very much for watching this episode. I hope you learned a bit. And feel free to comment, subscribe to this video, and see you in the next one.